this is the final boss, and this is ADACA. The developers were kind enough to share a key with me for this game to try it out, so I'm excited to see what we have. Primary campaign, story-driven, linear narrative. I'm very excited to see about that. Zone patrol, non-linear open world. Okay, so I'm going to start with the story-driven narrative because you know what? I'm a narrative designer, and that's what I like to see. ADACA campaign. Play as Jesse Thorne in this story-driven linear adventure broken up into multiple episodes. I wish they'd actually, tell me a little bit about what kind of story I'm getting into. Yeah, we'll do normal. Start with tutorial, aim assist. Okay. Alright, you know what? Let's just get into it. Unit ID, CF something, Jesse Thorne. So again, you've kind of told me twice who I'm being. Gender non-binary, criminal charge, destruction of company property. Yikes. $40 million of company property. 20 years in conscription service with Masha's privilege. Submit for combat training. Alright, I'm going in. So again, I like the fact that as I get into this, I liked the fact that it used the form of like a military message to give me context about the world. In bougie writing places, they call it polyphony, but it's essentially using different languages from different areas. So there's someone talking to you, their dialogue is kind of a tone of voice. The way like someone read a report or like a military report, like the one we just read, it makes the world feel more filled out. So I think overall, something to look good. Okay, whoa, mouse, look around. Yep, got that. Yep. Of MASH's private military corporation, cool. Nice. I can punch. A neural implant has been surgically integrated into your cerebral cortex. Yikers. It's installed a minimum required combat training into your memory as well as integrated heads-up display. Minister, I mean, that's funny that they have the HUD as part of the narrative. The ability to administer chemical disciplinary measures since you failed to begin obstacle training. I don't want to. Exit. Oh, I kind of wanted to see if they would actually, like, punish me. So I would let that exit door open, but then it, like, starts, zapping you or something. I think that could be a really fun additional mechanic here. Oh, I thought I just jumped. Do I have to, like, run? Yeah. I mean, this is using, like, I don't know if this all needs to get tutorialized necessarily. Oh, crouch soon after jumping to vault. Weapons training, let's go. Yeah. So a lot of this tutorialization, I feel like, is telling me stuff that, like, every game uses. So one thing I would tell to the game developers is use the tutorial to show me the unique aspects of the game and maybe give me an option to be like, hey, have you ever played a shooter before? And then I can shoot like yes or no. And then if I shoot no, then it's like, do you want me to really explain WASD and mouse to look around and like, shift to run and left control to crouch and... Move to the next bench and pick up a rifle. Oh, I guess there's one here. Alright, pick up grenades. So like this, like the G feels a little funkier. Usually I think grenades are like Q. Oh, this mother lover. A little funky, but nothing terrible. What's this do? Okay, cool. Heals me. Did not need... Candino. So I do love the tone of this very antagonistic corporation. I I like this kind of like, unfortunately, they can't hurt you. That is a really great. Hello, friends. Ooh, hi. I guess I'm at full health. Okay. Wow, the mouse is really fast on this. Maybe I'll turn down my... And now my DPI. Looks like headshots do more. See, so, yeah, I mean, honestly, like I feel like some of the aspects of this tutorial are... Ooh, wow. Probably should have thrown a grenade at them, but despite it all, your training is complete. So again, really love the dialogue's voice, right? Like the dialogue kind of has this really antagonistic, it's not wishing me to succeed, it's mad at me, storage just at once. I think that's really, really nice. I thought I got shot a few times. Let's go. Let's shoot me off into space, please. Take me, gravity. ADACA. ADACA, ADACA, ADACA. Alright. So again, honestly, the thing that... Two things for the tutorial is I would shorten it quite a bit. Let's see if it'll... Wait. Okay. Hold still, just a few more tweaks. You've been asleep for a while. Yes, I was. They left newcomers around these tubes for who knows how long. Wow, that's rude. What? Interesting. So I was with the corporation at first. What is? Oh, something hit me? Oh, hi, friend. Is this where I want to be? No. I didn't know what else to do. I seppuku'd, I guess. Well, it was nice while it lasted. Okay, but before we get in, so overall, the intro. I do think the WASD aspects of teaching me, like, hey, look around, move around, control to crouch, you know, shift to run. I think there's a lot simpler ways to do that, and I think that is probably the unnecessary parts of the tutorial, or maybe the optional parts. We say, hey, if you need more basic shooter, just like WASD and stuff like that, click here. If not, don't. I liked in the tutorial the aspects of it that really got me familiar with the tone, like how antagonistic this corporation is. And, like, just that they're not nice guys, you know? Alright, I got this. You gonna try coming at me, bro? Hello? Oh, I can use that? Oh, whoops. Uh-oh. I don't think I want to be down here. So what am I supposed to do? Go to the bow of the vessel? Maybe I do want to be down here. I don't know. Well, I do not want to be down there. Alright, I will say I do need a little bit of direction, kind of, like, maybe I'm just dumb. I might be the, I mean, hey, this is a good test, right? I thought I messed up because I was supposed to, like, hurl this at the enemy ship and take out its gun or something, but I might be mistaken. What is? Ow. Alright, maybe that's just not something I need to mess with right now. Got it. I think I'm picking up what y'all are putting down. Okay, I'm full health. We're gonna go in here. Alright, I think that's what I just needed to do that. Got it. Alright, I'm dumb. Got it. Hi. I do like the art, honestly. I didn't think I would. It kinda looked kinda weird and blocky. Ah, stupid thing. It always does that. Okay, but why though? Guess we go this way then. Oh, interesting. Yeah, this is pretty interesting. So these are the tutorial elements I need. That's my homie over there. Alright, where to now, my dude? This way? I wish I could sight with this. I keep pressing. Oh! What's just shooting at me, man? This guy? Oof, get wrecked. That's a pretty cool mechanic, that my little cybernetic magic arm. Oh, should have grabbed that. Oof, ow. Okay. Can I go in here? Oh, I got some more ammo. Are there more friends? Oof. All right, I think we killed a few guys. Got some more ammo. A little low on, not too low on life, but a little bit low on life. I will say, I wish the, when I drew an item in towards myself, it didn't block so much of my screen. I wish it was like maybe really around my hand, because I can't really see where I'm aiming with one of these. I mean, that might be the point, but it's not as interesting if I can't really aim very well. Other conscripts were woken up generations ago, but the town on this derelict, trading food supplies, they called themselves the Free Scrappers. Oh, nice. Well, I guess the cops are out here for the company. Is this where I'm supposed to be? I'm a little scared of wandering in the wrong place, because last time I got the old... this. Something blew up. Alright, what do I do? So, like, this is better, because I can still see where I'm targeting, but, like, those bigger boxes does block my vision. Oh, I'd have to, like, put it in here. Oh. Well, I'll be. That's cool. I really wish I had that rifle. I liked the rifle a lot. But again, I like that also the tutorial is part of the story. Is this my homie? No, that's my homie. Let me go through. Whew. Oof. Oh, there's a sniper guy. Okay, I gotta get in here. Whoa. Woof. Is there one of those little healing things around here? Oh, shoot. Hey, dude. Thought you were my friend. Looks like my health does regen a little bit on its own. So that AI was a little weird. Oh, I see. So if I kill them, I seem to get health packs. Oof, get wrecked. Oh, that's my homie. Okay. I mean, it looks like this, like, thing is really effective, right? I don't love that they're swearing as I'm shooting them, like, because to some degree, you know, I do understand that it adds authenticity, that they're like, oh, F-words, like, every time I shoot them, but it's also, like, you know, something to think about as a game designer is it's narrowing your audience, right? Like, the more kind of, you know, adult content I put in here, the less of an audience I have. And it's nothing bad. Like, if this was the game you want to build, it's the game you want to build. The streams were AK Kumar committed the fleet that was housed, but it was stolen a long time ago. Wonder, is that what the police are looking for? Meet you back up in town. Okay. I have a feeling you're going to seppuku somehow. I have a feeling that guy's going to somehow sacrifice himself. By pressing F6. Oh, cool. All right. I like that we actually use our F keys. Someone's shooting. Oh, my gracious. I'll use F. Oh, hi. These guys don't seem very smart. I mean, that guy was staring right at me, and I didn't seem to draw aggro. I mean, maybe these are just the intro-level baddies, which is fine. Oof, sorry, dude. This is explosives. I do like that it's playable, right? Like, I'm not very good at shooters, but I feel like I am having fun. I'm able to engage. And you'll see from some of the other streams, if you watch more streams on this channel, that's not always the case. Sometimes, you know, these, you know, they really want to teach you if you're good or bad at something, you know? Okay, this is where I came in. Got my healing pod. I'm down here. I do wish there was a little bit more directionality. Like, I mean, these are pretty linear levels, which I appreciate. What do? How do? I see. Yeah, I mean, I feel like this Q ability is really strong, so I understand why perhaps I guess I could have like just shot them off, but I guess I needed to be there, huh? Oh, interesting. Wouldn't let me use it. Interesting. New core. It's kind of where I want to be, right? Oh, hi, friends. Oh, God. Come on, take it. There it goes. I wish the hitboxes were a little bit more forgiving, but I appreciate, I mean, it's fine. I get that, like, this is, I just can't see a gosh darn thing. It's very difficult to see, I feel like. Oh, that's gonna come back and hit my ass. But I do feel like this push and pull mechanic, it's not something, whoa, hello, friendo. It's not something I've... Where's something I can throw? So I want to get down to him. So I'm going to try to maybe run on these pipes. Because that guy had a good gun. Ow. I hear more cops. I don't know if I want to go down. I do want to go down there. That looks... Okay, that looks okay. That looks safe-ish. I just need to find a gentle path down here. How much do I have? Decent amount. Oh, snap. Oof. All right, all right. I did like that. That was a more intense section. I do feel like, you know, I'm not very good at shooters, so I do feel like it's, more challenging for me, at least. Woo! Who's next? I don't love that the muzzle flash shows up on my zoom. So you see the way the muzzle flash shows up on the bottom? I think that's something to maybe tweak. It's a little distracting, and I don't see that happening. Do I really want to open up the airlock? I mean, what? I mean, there's nothing else to click, so I'm doing it. Seems good. Seems good. Seems good. Okay. All right. All right. Episode 1. Derelict. Man, that's a Zoolander quote right there. Overall, cool game. I liked that within the first few minutes, I was in combat, I was playing, even when I chose the extra tutorial. These Vitas cycle through different grenades. V. I don't have that many different... Okay, there we go. So these are my Molotovs. Are you friend? You are friend. Alright, cool. Hi. I don't know what that was. What was that? Bonk. Alright. I do like the art style. I think it's... Whoa. Can I just paddle the boat instead of... Okay, at least I can swim and not die. That's great. Water is sometimes spells instant death in certain games. So, it looks like I want to kind of weasel my way over here. What? What I got there, but all right. Okay. Got, I guess, another shield. So I think I'm trying to get over there, essentially. I mean, I do like that the map lays out in a way where 90% of the time... 90% of the time... Oops. Yeah, I'm on it, right? No. I can kind of get what I'm supposed to do. There is still that 10% of the time where I'm not 100%. Tracking on everything. Hi, friend. Seems we're fixing for a fight. Thankfully, it's how the carry came and gave us a little bit of aim on sneaking up into some outposts. So, some good things about the dialogue. I like that we're starting a little bit in the middle of action. Like, these are people who know context, who are filling me in. I also like that... this character has a different way of speaking. We see M, you know, sneaking them, us few volunteers, you know, those types of idiomatic phrases are really nice. And it tells me, you know, at least in the dialogue layer, that Kelly is different, maybe from a different background than the guy with the glasses. Things don't go south. Well, I don't know. All right, cool. I don't know either. Can I go in here? Ooh, boxes. I guess this is like over shields. I don't know. I mean, I'll take it. I guess. I like that there are some little like extra items I can get if I wander aimlessly. Wow, took that whole soda machine, huh? Dang. You friend? You friend. I mean, the art of this game is surprisingly nice. I didn't think I would like the vault. We're looking to repossess our salvage. That's the town's dang entire economy. F that, the free strappers ain't about to lie down on this one. So again, I do see now that, hey, kind of you're looking for, this is a more adult-themed game where there are going to be more kind of advanced, you know, and more grown-up language. Biohazard, all these things. Pull through, eh, friend? Join our coast little village, yes. Do I need to run? Okay. They're firing on the town! It's like Russia. Do I have a... Oop, hello. Is that a soldier? What you doing up there, stinker? I do wish I could see, or maybe like if the item was a little translucent when I was holding it, that would be really nice. I understand like part of it is just maybe it's just too strong. No ammo, are you kidding me? Oh, that's my homegirl, okay. Need to hold him off. Where's the dropship is? Okay, tried. Somebody shoot me? Oh, hey. Excuse you. Get some chair! I wish I had a melee! Seems like it's, and my little arm like launches the Moses out of stuff that literally went into the stratosphere. I don't love that it's like respects it doesn't let me like continue to hold on to it. Okay, I cannot throw stuff. Oh. Shooting at my friend? Who's shooting my friend? They're breaking through! Where? No, that's not friend. I will say, like, the enemy, like, freak-out lines are a little repetitive. Oh, I can take their guns? That's pretty sick. That's pretty cool. Think it's clear. It's a free scapper outpost that way. Go through the dam. I'm guessing this is the dam. Alright. What? This way? Oh. Someone's getting lit up. Flowers? Can I pick these nice flowers? I cannot. I might be in trouble. Oh my god, shoot me out of there. Oh, I tried to press F. I guess I don't have a... Do I have a bash? Oh, I had grenades, too. Darn, I forgot about my grenades. Looking away for the useful items. Well, if you say so. Alright. I kind of am figuring this out slowly. But it's cool. I actually am quite impressed. It's not always the free games that I get are all that impressive, I will say. Sometimes they're a little bit cringy. Shoot your tootsies. Oof, that hurts. Let's collect all the ammo I can. Yeah, you really gotta use Q, which I kinda like, you know, it's the mechanic of this game. You know, it's like kind of the new thing this game is bringing. And you kinda, and they are, well, hello, you friend. Hi, friend. Oh, I guess this was a secret thing. What is... We'll do G that way. No. Okay. Okay. Why do? How do? I guess I have to go that way. Got it. That guy literally exploded. That's a little gruesome. What are you, enemy? That's a smidge gruesome. Hi. Honestly, this is a pretty darn cool game, I gotta admit. I'm kind of impressed. Oh, is that my homie? Well, enjoy that, punks! What did I do to switch grenades? It was... V? Yeah, there we go. I took a lot of damage there. Are we clear? We'll go down here first. See if there's anything to get. Okay. And these coppers. The coppers are coming for me, huh? Kablooey. Saving. Okay, so something's gonna go down pretty soon. Oh, I think this is the end of the dam, right? Wow, I did it! Chapter 2? Am I on Chapter 2? Grenades will explode with a shot, even if there's something in someone's hand, I'm guessing. I like the loading screen tips. Those are always such a helpful way of, like, I'm staring at, if I have to stare at my computer at a loading screen anyways. Where? Oh, hi, friend. Oh, my God. Phew! That guy smoked me. I wish I could get some armor or something. I got hit twice and died, and I did not know where they were coming from. Alright, well, I better check my six next time. Oh, those are sniper guys. Got it. I had to light that boy up. Peace out, dude. Sorry. Can I go up here and find something? Okay. Thought that would be kind of a cool thing if there was something at the top of the water tower, but that's okay. Use E. What? It said use something. Oh, that was a bad idea. Oh, snap. Okay. Ooh, I should have moved. Guy got me in the old dome, in the chrome dome. Objects still being pulled towards you can deal damage to enemies. Alright, this started me back a little bit. It's already getting late, but overall, this is a cool game. I'm actually quite surprised. A lot of these projects that I find aren't always as developed. But yeah, I think in terms of art style, I don't love the voxel style, kind of like this like blocky, like Minecrafty style, but it's executed pretty darn well, and so I'll say it's a good 8 out of 10. Gameplay feels really good. Obviously it sounds like you can remap the controls. I do feel like there is some optimizing in terms of, like, you know, F is kind of my interaction, so, like, I would feel like F should pull things towards me. There's a few little tweaks, but overall it feels pretty cool. It does feel really spiky in terms of damage. Like, you know, I'm either just be mauling enemies or I'm getting like two shots. So I'm not sure exactly like what is causing the differentiation there. But it is something, it feels like. I don't know if I should be like looking to pick up one of these sniper rifles. Okay. So yeah, is this like a sniper? I don't know. Oh. Oh, that's a shotgun. Okay. So there are different weapons. I do wish there was some indicator about like, hey, this is a shotgun, this is a whatever, 'cause it's not super clear. Except by like looking at it, maybe. So that's my like battle rifle, I guess. So I got more guns now. Dual burst, alt. Oh, I see, that's my right trick. Alt scope, I see. Interesting, interesting. That guy popped me. All right, anyways, but yeah, this is cool. Honestly, I'm very impressed with this game. I'd say the gameplay is a solid 7 out of 10. I think that kind of. Like, I get sniped once, I'm dead. I didn't even know it was coming. Like, for those distant sniper enemies, that doesn't feel tuned. Where, you know, when I'm close to an enemy, they're telling me, oh, crud, like, this guy's here, I'm in trouble. But for those distant enemies, it's not quite as clear. So I would try to think about that as you all tune the game, how to manage those distant enemies. Like, a lot of, you know, games use like a tracer sight or like a red line for like, hey, there is a sniper shot coming here. If you're still standing here, you're in trouble. But obviously, I'm just not very good at these. You know, I'm not very good at games in general. So maybe that's just me being bad. But yeah, like the narrative was interesting. I think there are ways to improve it. If you're curious, feel free to reach out. But yeah, I think the narrative overall is doing a lot of things right, you know, giving me ex, you know, giving me exposition, you know, giving me a tone of this company that's really dark, you know, like, you know, the using polyphony, using some s different sources of voice, like, you know, hey, one is like a military message, one is what the soldiers say, one is what this guy with the glasses says, one is, you know, what this lady that kind of has a southern accent says. So I get a lot of different tones, which makes the world feel very filled out. And yeah, there's honestly not a lot to complain about. I would give this game, I think it's, I don't know if it's a demo, but I'd give it an 8 out of 10. Honestly, it's a really fun game. I'm kind of impressed. And I think it actually adds that new push and throw mechanic, which is kind of interesting. Both for puzzle solving, where you push some of those things, you grab the thing to throw it. I think that still could use refinement. Like, I feel like if I pull an object, oh, that's a sniper rifle. So again, yeah. Like, the fact that it's not telling me what this is a little woof. So, yeah, I mean, there was like a sniper leaning there, but there should be some sort of like indicator that this is a shotgun, this is a sniper. You know, this is kind of the table stakes for that. But yeah, so this is like a real sniper. Oh my god, I want to just try it out. Oh yeah, that's a real sniper, it looks like. But again, like, hard for me to tell what was what there. Did I just flatten them both with one shot? Holy moly. Get those guns out of here. All right, so I really okay. So that's the thing. Like, this is pretty gun dependent, right? Like, I needed to. So I don't want to drop my like sweet sniper. So it's either shotgun or sniper. Okay. Interesting. Well, I definitely need a sniper here. Yeah, that makes this a whole lot more manageable. Yeah, I mean, the fact that I'm still trying to play and figure this out, like, is telling you a lot. Like, most of the time, there's not much incentive for me to, like, keep playing, right? Like, when I'm like, oh, like, this was a cool game, but it's missing something or what have you. But honestly, I'm quite impressed. I'm gonna go ahead and press my F6 to save. Like that it just lets me do that. That's really nice to not have to wait for save points. Anything in here? Anything? There's a keg. Alright, nothing much. Well, there's a ladder, so I probably need to like go down there, go up there, and then hurry before the train gets in, huh? Is that what I'm thinking? I'll put this in the track. Okay, that was not very effective. Got it. Got it. Oh, I missed. All right, well, overall, this is a pretty cool game. I gotta say I'm impressed. Normally these little games I get for free are not a are you know they're still early, they're still in the demo phase, they still have a lot of dev. This feels really rounded out. I would encourage them to keep tuning the story. That is one of the areas that I think has a lot of potential but feels a little soft. I do want more of an emotional connection with these characters and just not the fact of like them. All the dialogue, though it is in its own voice, is just telling me exposition. I think that's a really big opportunity to give me some emotional stakes in this story, and I think it will add a lot more. So I would encourage you to look into that. Obviously, everybody's a little different, but man, y'all have done great on this game so far, and I would encourage you to keep up the great work, and I can't wait to see what y'all come up with next. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.